Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Isaac. Today we are jumping in and doing something a little different. I'm going to start up a streak on another save file here. It's not something that we're going to do all the time, it's just going to be thrown in maybe once or twice a week on occasion when I feel like it. But I thought it could be fun to try and build up a streak of wins to see how far we can go with like a modded setup. We'll still get to see super cool modded items and stuff, and we'll still have our character showcases and stuff on occasion on other days. But I thought this would be fun to kind of min-max and see if we can get a win streak going. We're going to jump right in. And just right off the bat, I want to ask a question of the day. What is your highest win streak? And along with that, what is your highest losing streak? Right, what we started with here, let's have a little look-see. So, we've got Gun That Kills the Past, removes the oldest item from your inventory, including quest items, three choices appear. And we have five luck at the minute. So, Fortunes Grub, all beggars and slot machines will display a fortune alongside their possible payouts. And we get plus five luck. Okay, interesting. This active item is going to be good if we get some bad items on occasion. We've also started with pretty decent stats here, which is rather nice. But yeah, I think my highest losing streak is probably about 145. I don't know exactly. It's definitely 140 something. And that was OG. OG lost. Rebirth lost. That was probably about 400 or 500 hours into having played the game, so I was reasonably experienced. But honestly, I'd say Isaac is one of those games where you're not really that good at it until about sort of 700-800 hours, which is mental for a game to say that like it can take that long to be good at it. But I'd say I'm reasonably good at the game now. I can win Fiend Folio runs reasonably often, and Fiend Folio is a reasonably hard mod, and I'm saying reasonably quite a lot right now. Which is reasonable. Ooh, Soiled Heart's pretty nice here. Our item is going to be our Pot of Gold. Converts all your bombs, keys, and most coin pickups into rainbow pennies. Very good stuff. Pot of Gold is a really fun item. Allows us to basically get a bunch of varieties of pennies. We no longer get keys and bombs, though. We have to get those through pennies. So they're going to be slightly more of a hot commodity. But there's also the potential we get way more of them. It's kind of like a sort of... could be one way or the other. Probably should have tried to look for secret room with that guy. In fact, we can look for it with this guy here, so I'll see if I can make it work. Right. There you go. And we get a soul heart penny there. Ah, no secret room. Yeah, we got soul heart penny there. I'll go and clear the floor. We are trying to win here, so min-maxing is going to be part of the game we're playing here. We do want to make sure to be finding our secret rooms, destroying stuff for pennies, all that sort of good stuff. Trying to take advantage of every floor as much as we can to secure a win. It doesn't mean I'm going to min-max on every floor, because once we get to the womb and onwards, if I already know that I've got a pretty good chance of winning, I'm not going to be min-maxing crazy-like. But I will try my best. Oh, no. Oh, I knew I was going to get hit there. I kind of misplayed that with this little b-boy here. We got him. This is why I want to min-max here. We just got a bunch of butt pennies there. Lovely. But it should mean that we can afford shop items a lot more readily, which is really nice because we can get some pretty good stuff from the shop. I don't think we're going to end up getting a shop item this floor, but we've got a few big rooms here, so I got to play for the chance. I got to do these extra rooms just for the opportunity. Also, we're getting a lot of these honey pennies, which are really nice. Oh, that was kind of a near hit there. Good. Yeah, we started with pretty good damage here, which is really, really nice. And yeah, as for like if the streak is going to be Eden only, I'm not entirely sure. I do prefer Eden just because it's a bit more random. Ooh, we get ourselves a card penny there. Chariot card. Unfortunately, not in a room that matters too much. Those are a bit risky because that can be any old card and cause some severe problems for us, I imagine. But I took the risk and didn't end up paying out too badly. Chariot card is not detrimental to us, at least. Not really good for us, but as long as it's not detrimental, that's my biggest hope. Hey, getting some dips here. And there you go, we got a bomb. Nice one. So, in terms of secret room here, do I have a slam dunk? Do I have a slam dunk? Secret room could well be here. I think it is, to be honest. Yeah, this looks about right. I'm going to destroy this as well, one sec. Fortunately, not the payout I was hoping for, but thank you. I'm not entirely sure this isn't exactly a slam dunk, yeah, but I thought I'd give it a go anyways. I had to try it. Right. Remember as well, if we get a bad boss item, we do have our Gun That Can Kill the Past. Now, the question with our Gun That Can Kill the Past, actually, The new items are from the same pool as your lost. Okay. So if we delete an item, it comes from the same pool as the item we deleted it from. So we don't want to be trading in boss items, really, because we'll just get three more boss items, unless it's like the box or something. Because the box or like booster pack, I'm pretty sure booster pack's a boss item, right? We get the value and then can get rid of the item for basically a free item on top of it. So items like that I'll go for. But other ones that I'll probably just keep. Even HP, I'll probably just keep. Actually, to be fair, HP is also one that works like that, doesn't it? Immobilized and forced to consume 7 random pills. Nice, okay. The pills are dangerous, but we didn't get anything too bad there, and we gained a good amount of damage, a little bit of speed, a little bit of range. All good. And I think we are going to take the alt path for our first win potential here. I would like to try and mix in some alt path wins with the Beast and Mother, because people said they wanted them more often. And this is one of the reasons I want to do the streaks as well. Provides us with more opportunity to see modded stuff interact with each other, but also more opportunity to like go to some of the custom floors and some of the modded floors as well. Like, oh my god, this floor, annoying. Another poop friend. I do like having this soiled heart. I really hope we can keep it for a decent amount of time, because it's very, very useful for just creating a good amount of dips. And some of those dips can be pretty darn strong. They're not always, but they can be. The opportunity is there. Right, we've got our little wormwood guy over here. He's going to be a bit of a nuisance, but luckily doesn't have a lot of health. Yeah, so at the minute, we're still waiting on an item that will be ideal for us to trade out with our gun that can kill the past, which is an Enter the Gungeon reference, by the way. Burns, blood penny. Yeah, care of them. At the minute, I'm just very happy that our damage is very much keeping up. It's a little bit ahead of the curve right now, which isn't what I expected. And today, I've got something arriving today that I'm very excited about. I've had this keyboard that I'm using for a very long time. It's a Corsair K15 or something. I can't remember the exact name of it now. But it's about a 40 quid keyboard. It's not very expensive. I had it for a long time. It's actually my second one of this keyboard because I do quite like it. But I've gone all out and got a really, really nice, pricey keyboard, finally. I got a Keychron Q15, I think it is. It sounds pretty saucy. It's got some really, really cool extra features, and just it'll be a keyboard that feels really nice to use and stuff. I've never really gone for anything pricey in that regard, so I'm kind of excited to see how it is and how it feels, because I've only really used cheap keyboards, and I'm pretty sure it's a full metal keyboard as well, whereas this one that I'm using is plastic, so it will just feel a lot higher quality and should hopefully last me a longer time. So that's supposed to arrive today. I'm pretty excited to see that and set it up and try playing some games on it. It'll be really, really interesting, because I've never really even touched like a proper, like, nice keyboard. Like, I've never really been to like a friend's house that's had one, or known anyone that's had like a really good keyboard. Probably the priciest one I've ever touched is like maybe £100, which isn't really that much when it comes to like professional keyboards, or like, I won't say professional as such, but you know what I mean. So unfortunately at the minute we are looking for a key, which is problematic because there's only one way for us to get a key. And it would be to either buy one from the shop, which we need a key to do, or to find a penny which contains the key, a flat penny. So, little bit risky there. Hello, Mr. Crocodile. I love the fact they made them actually make crocodile sounds. It's actually pretty cute attention to detail there. Yeah, because at the minute we're just getting regular pennies. So we are going to be potentially a bit starved for consumables because of Pot of Gold. But saying that, Pot of Gold used to be incredibly overpowered, so I don't blame them for nerfing it a little bit. It's definitely not as good as it used to be, and it has some risk associated with it nowadays. Before, it used to be like a slam dunk. Oh, there you go, we got one. You'd just be winning your runs constantly, and you'd have like unlimited bombs and keys and stuff. It was pretty nuts. So now it's not quite as crazy as it once was. But we did get a key here, so we can actually go to our item room and see what's what. Of course, going to the alt path as well, we have a choice. And obviously, we're going to take Conehead here. Thank God I took it as well, because I did not want IBS. That would have been pretty disgusting. Nobody wants IBS in real life or Isaac. I'll destroy these as well. I'm going to say, mainly because we could get a penny. Pennies are nice, but those pennies could contain other things. Now, I could gamble on a curse room for a soul heart, but I think that's a little bit of a steep gamble, to be honest. I'd rather just get going. At the minute, I have no use for my active item, though. I've not had a single item that I want to get rid of yet. Conehead is pretty good defensively. I picked the wrong one. Now, this guy's going to be a little annoying because we do not have a bomb to kill him with. Typically, this guy is a much, much easier boss if you have a bomb to work with. We're going to have to forego that strategy. But I don't know, we're killing him pretty fast. We do have quite a lot of damage. Now, we've got to be really careful about where he creates his pits here, because we could easily get ourselves stuck if we're not, like, if we don't place things in the right place here. We need to make sure there's enough gaps. Luckily, that wasn't too hard, and these guys are all one-shot lovely. Okay, he's very, very nearly dead here. Oh, hello. I didn't realize you spewed these guys out. We got one of these heads here. That's from our Kicks and Giggles mod. Now, in terms of Devil Deal, I don't think I'm going to go for that. I think we're not quite there. I'll keep the speed here, though. Still waiting on, like, the best item to go for. What will be nice, if we get a bad angel deal, we can retcon it and trade it for a different one. So, I think we get three uses of our gun that can kill the past. From usually your oldest item, or is it just one use? It might just be one use, I'm not sure. I think it might just be one use. But it's potentially really good for us. I think if we get an angel deal, that's where we want to use it. If we get a bad angel deal item, that is, we might end up getting something really good. You never really know. So mini Isaacs is rather nice. They'll help out quite a bit. Got a boss trap room here. Ooh, very nice. Do we have a secret room? Nah, we don't. Okay, do we have one at the other side? I want to get into my boss trap room via secret room, but not always plausible. Hello, good sir. That might be a decent use of our money. Now, I'm going to wait until we see what our item room and boss give us first, just because we've got a higher chance of beating that if we have more things either defensively or offensively, right? So, better to wait it out. And that's the sort of min-maxing that I'm going to bring to the streak here. Also, another thing about, like, these episodes, they're going to be slightly more about, like, the theory behind the decisions I make and stuff. Ah, speed down. Luckily, we've had a lot of speeds up, so that's not too bad. Yeah, there's going to be slightly more talk about, like, the decisions I'm making and kind of the theory of why I'm doing stuff and what decisions I'm making than a regular run. To sort of be, like, a bit more tutorialized for people that are struggling with the game, because I know there's still a lot of new people to Isaac out there. And by new, I mean sub 500 hours. And that means that people are still looking to learn. And I think I can provide a lot in that aspect. Another bomb there, lovely. I'm looking for a cash room here, because we just got a Phantom Pains pill, and we can actually use the iframes from a Phantom Pains pill to get into our cash room. I'm not sure how often it does them, though, because it hasn't even proc'd once yet. We do have a good amount of money now, so shop would be valuable if we can get the keys to make it work. Really? Just all pills? Hey, tears up, though. We do not mind that at all. I don't think the Phantom Pains pill worked, you know. I think that's bugged. Because I don't seem to be having any Phantom Pains right now. This is a very annoying boss. I don't even know what hit me there, but I managed to open my secret room. That's very nice. Good. And what do you have for us? Spawn three random pills. Ooh. Oh, there you go. Some horse pills. Lovely. That was a big old half. Wow. That one was a little mean. A little mean there, game. I just got a double bad trip, so I've now got no soul heart protection, which when you're going for win streaks is not the ideal, I've got to say. Not what you're hoping for. We do have a rainbow poop, though, which will heal us back to full if we do take some damage. Beautiful. Stuff. Still, unfortunately, low on keys. But I think that's going to be the case for pretty much the whole run at this point. As I said, we destroy our poops and stuff in the hopes that we get more. Oh, got a black heart. Petrified poop is amazing for us right now. More pennies from poops is really good for us. We did get a key here. Model rocket is an interesting one. I think I'll take it. I think I'll take it. Oh, the Blood Puppy would have been a gorgeous boy to have. I quite like Model Rocket. Basically, the higher our shot speed, the more damage we do, and we do have a good amount of shot speed right now. We've had 2 shot speeds up so far. So I think that's pretty good. I'm going to bomb am I going to bomb our mirror, or should I actually do the mirror challenge? I want to go Mother, so maybe I should just not bother with bombing the mirror until after. But we should now go and do the boss while we have this little friend of ours, the Holy Dip, because they are very, very strong. That's going to increase our damage by a lot, give us homing, and give us protection as well. So let's get in there. Basically, we just got to stand in the radius of this. Oh, dude, all the golden pennies have random effects. We got a pill there. We got a key as well. We got tons of money to work with. Golden pennies are pretty amazing for us right now. You can see how much more damage we're doing while standing in the radius of this dip here. I'm trying to make sure he doesn't touch the boss so he doesn't die. Hey, more shot speed. I'm actually pretty down with that right now. And 10 burn orbitals. Lovely. Right, cool. Okay. Just going to quickly go to our shop. Shibbity shibbity shop. What we got going on here? Restores half a heart each time you swallow a pill. Spawns a pill upon pickup. That's pretty good. We'll take that. And we'll also take that as well. I'll bomb him for some more money. Ooh. This is kind of a tricky one. I think we stick with Petrified Poop just for the higher chance of getting coins overall. Right. Got to be careful here. We are at risk, but we've got a lot of protection with our burn orbitals and now the wisps that we have. So we shouldn't be too bad off here. Boom, boop. But still, I'm yet to find an item that I really want to trade. Ooh, that's very, very nice. Pop it. I'm honestly pretty tempted to go do my boss as long as this dip stays alive. If this dip stays alive, I'm very interested in doing my boss. Otherwise, I'm a little wary. But I also want to just, like, pass through the rooms here to, get more stuff, destroy more poops, and find more, pennies and stuff. I knew you'd appear over here. Ooh, a red chest. Hello. Some more pills. I don't need to take those right now unless we know what they are. Honestly, I know what my tears up pill is now, so I'm, like, holding out for that, really. Honestly, one thing that's really, really good about this Holy Dip as well is the way that the homing triggers is that lower shot speed is better. And because our tiers start with such low shot speed, the homing is really, really heavy. Nice. Right. Boss time. Now, this boss is a bit risky, I will say, but I think we've got this guy under wraps. No, 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 no. Aw, you bastard. I saw it coming. I've got so much protection that I shouldn't die here, but I knew he was going to destroy my friend. And speedball. Nice. Makes up some of our lost speed earlier. And even more shot speed. Okay, so we are doing some crazy damage right now because of our shot speed. Let's make sure to grab our knife piece and we'll be on our merry little way. We've got 2 bombs to work with for our door and 1 bomb for the mirror so we get an increased reflected item chance. I always like to do if I can remember to do it. We bomb that. Cracks the little mirror there. Cool, okay. Oh, I'm not used to not having flight. And we got a good amount of stuff. 3 bombs, 1 key for the next floor. 24 coins for the next shop as well. Good stuff, good stuff. Right, let's bomb this bad boy. Looking like a decent run for Mother so far. I'm liking it. Bomb beggar, unfortunately, you're not really going to get a word in edgeways. Cast the void. As a reflected. Yeah, I'll crack that. It's a regular chest, but that'll give us plenty of potential pennies, right? So, oh, we got a curse penny. So, that room is taken care of. Don't remember what you do. Dude, when our rockets are reaching full shot speed, they are doing some crazy damage. Oh god. I've never seen these enemies do that before. Oh, they like rehydrate. I won't say hydrate aspect, but they like put themselves back on fire. This looks secret ruby to me. And it was. Ooh. This is a good trinket, right? Beating the floor without taking damage. Ooh, okay, okay, okay. I can get behind that. Petrified Poop's good, but this is currently plus one tiers up, and it will upgrade itself if we can beat floors without taking damage, which isn't guaranteed, but is plausible. Do not like these little underground fellas, I will say. Also, really don't like you. I'm going to take you out with wisps, to be honest, because I don't like the idea of getting back there and doing what you want me to do. Why do my wisps keep missing? This is tedious as hell. And go straight in here. Evil sticker. Not that good. Got an arcade back there as well. That could be good. Yeah, we're just keeping our range here, so it's kind of like having a lump of coal in a way. That's a regular red heart. Hey, there's another key for our item room when we get there. Good stuff, baby. Good stuff. Yeah, even though our other trinket, Petrified Poop, could give us more stuff, we're not as likely to find poops now, so I think taking the plus one fire rate is huge in general, but trying to then upgrade it even further to... I think it becomes damage next floor, and then it becomes damage and fire rate by level 3. I'm going to take random here. Metronome. Damn. It's annoying as well, because we can't even use our active on that. Bit of a shame, that. Gotcha. An extra bomb. Looking for another key, though. We'll go to our arcade and see what we can get out of that. I'm pretty jazzed about an arcade here. Don't remember what these little things do, but I'm scared by them. We got a sack room here. There's a lot of red hearts on this floor, so a sack room is not an entirely crazy play. Ow. Ooh, and we got one of these little thingy boys as well. We need to finish out this room too, actually. Ah, really? Okay. At this point, I'm pretty on board to play a sack room. Because we just got a Justice and a Sun. Dude, yeah, this is definitely, like, we definitely do this. Like, sack room is totally on the cards for us right now. Right. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. We got our angel deal. Can I get rid of this item, I wonder? Where would the blue key be here? Like, how would I get to this? A good item. I don't think our active would work on the key piece, would it? So I'm not going to bother. There you go. Got a soul heart. Just shouldn't have picked it up. That was a bit stupid, actually. Quickly go back and grab a bunch more hearts. Cool. And I think one more player for the money slash soul hearts. I was kind of hoping for the money. Unfortunately, we didn't really get the best smattering of coins here. I was hoping to get a lot more value in terms of pickups, but still, not bad to have this much money, is it? Right, arcade time. See what we can get out of that. That was a good player there, though. Ooh, hello. Haven't seen one of you in a long time. Well, that was unfortunately not very lucrative for us. Wow, oh my god, that's a god tier item right there. Good stuff. That was pretty amazing. Oh, we also smelted our trinket at some point? Oh, hello. I didn't realize you moved around like that. Excuse me? Thank you for the cracked key. So let's just keep moving around, I guess. Interesting. Ah, really, bomb? Kidding me? Yeah, all hearts are blended now. Right, let's keep looking around for our machine. I'm gonna go back over this way and see if it's moved back this way anywhere. I've got to check for it. I don't know how many times it does that. Is it back in the arcade? No. Grab that. Okay. Can we find our machine anywhere else? That. Here it is. It's back again. Red room there. Lovely. Don't blow yourself up. Okay, can't blow itself up. Good. Oh, goddamn. We just took a bunch of pills. And that's a big old bad trip again. Go make our way towards the boss here. Gideon! I don't know how good our shotgun item is here, our angel one, but it seems to be doing pretty well. It's certainly making a big splash. Not very heavy range, though. Also leaves a lot of shit on the ground. Don't destroy my wisps, you fool. We have two done. Here you're doing your thing up there, Gideon. Not happening. Oh my god. Sometimes the shotgun effect just goes off like crazy. It seems to do an insane amount of damage if they all hit. We have to be quite close for that to happen. Not quite sure why it leaves so many marks on the ground, but it's kind of wild. Ow! Knocked me back into the enemy. Rude. Yeah, look at that. That's amazing. I'm on last wave now. Gonna spawn some stuff, my guy. Okay, these guys don't even want to move. Am I stuck at this side? Okay, no, there is one gap. Just all the way down here. Hey, Mr. Dolly. Lovely. All blended hearts look beautiful. Right. Got to go back and look for our machine again here. It's somewhere about, but I don't know where. I don't know how long it takes to disappear fully, or if it's like every teleport, it has a chance to disappear fully anyways. It might well be already gone. Oh, nope, it's there. Why does it keep doing this? Oh, hello, Enriched Soul, nice. Keeps dropping stuff on top of things that I can't get to. But moved again. No minimap icon for it, so we just gotta keep checking around. Oh, there you go, it's now broken. We got Consolation Prize, which is gonna give us +1 bomb and +1 damage. Nice. Ooh, Enriched Soul, actually, is probably an item I want to do this on. I'll give it a go. That's not 3 items, that's only 2. And also, they're both terrible. Oh, wait, what item did it get rid of? Oh! Have I been looking at this wrong the entire time? What item did it get rid of? I got rid of my oldest item. What item did I start with? Removes the oldest item from your inventory. Okay, that makes it a lot less desirable right now. Because, like, I like the old items that I've got. I thought it was the most recent, not the oldest. Which, yeah, maybe I want to take Metronome then. Because I don't want to get rid of the previous two, the last two items I have. What the hell did I start with? What did I remove? I can't even remember. Yeah, I'm gonna say Metronome. It's a crazy item. It can do some wacky stuff. So why not? I've not used it in a while. Also, we have a lot of charge pennies, so I want an active that can be charged up, really. Down we go. But pretty long floor. Pretty long floor. But this is what min-maxing's all about, baby. Trying to take advantage to the fullest. Hey, we got Grotto here as well. Nice. We got Prank Cookie for the room. Maybe we'll get a little death certificate action from Metronome. You never know. Metronome used to be a one-room charge, and I loved it when it was a one-room charge. Unfortunately, we no longer have the same level of awesomeness. It was a bit too overpowered. We get Ludo. Ooh, Ludo with a rocket is kind of fun. It's a very, very fast rocket. Quite speedy. I forget what a little bag of trash even does. Spawns flies, right? We just get how to jump. Did that work last time? Yeah, it doesn't seem to work. I don't know what broke Phantom Pains, but something has. Taking a lot of damage, but remember, I have an item that essentially makes me invincible, so it's not all that bad. I love the music down here. Boop, boop, ba-doop, do-dit. Oh no, the Phantom Pains worked there. Did something. We got a reflected random, or we got milk. I'm gonna go for the reflected random. Double ghost bombs. Not the best of the best, but... Are these guys gonna spew? Yep. Gonna spew a lot of blood at us. No mozzies, no. Ooh, Magic Fingers is a very good item for us, I think. We have so much money coming in all the time that we can take a lot of advantage of Magic Fingers in certain rooms. Maybe a bit more boring, but definitely strong. We'll probably look for Secret Room. Then we can probably skedaddle after that. Damn. Pretty terrible secret room there. Right. Let's go. Like, that's a lot of money to spend, obviously. That's way too much, but I just wanted to show the theory and practice there. Wow, the Bible. Also, only one key here, so... Spawns an item from a random pool and will either give broken hearts or remove hearts equivalent to Devil Deal. Ooh, interesting. Soul of Mastema. Singularity. Oh my god. Spawns a random pickup. Ooh, yeah. We're gonna take that now. Ten percent of chance of spawning an item from a random pool. Yeah, I think this is worth taking. Magic fingers, again, really good, but we can charge this up so fast. Oh, actually, does it still only charge by collecting pickups? Yeah, it does only charge by collecting pickups. Okay, so this still works as I thought. Okay. I've never had singularity on a character that isn't Tainted Andromeda before, so interesting to know that it doesn't just give items like it does with him. But it kind of makes sense because you're still getting items from item rooms. But the potential for this is large. Well, I don't know what this mushroom guy does. I've not seen him before. Kind of sketchy. See, that gave us two pips. I like that. If Phantom Pain's is working there. So, I just want to try this out. If I wait, how long do I have to wait for a Phantom Pain's again? I'm not going to wait forever. I do want to see how often I get a Phantom Pain's proc and see if I can use it to get in these for free. There you go. Yeah, okay. Kind of cool. Yeah, dude, look how many charges we're getting on our active here. Oh, teleport myself out before getting the black heart there. Honestly, just give me that. Go back in here. Give me that as well. The chance at an item is low, but it's there. I feel like the 10% chance for an item is good. And also, it's just like more ways of generating even more like keys and stuff, so... I'm down with it. Not quite as fun as Magic Fingers, I don't think. Actually, nah. Hard to say. Magic Fingers is more of a meme item, but this has more potential and is a bit more interesting. By the way, if you're wondering why I haven't got the key piece, know that I don't actually do the key piece run, because I'm modded, it's laggy as hell, so instead I just spawn it in later on. I know that technically I could get hit in them other things, it's kind of cheaty, but whatever. Ooh, I would very much like a cracked dice shard. Also, would you like some pennies, my guy? Hello, little crown. Right, Devil, I'll just pop. Devil. Range down, no thank you. Bad trip, no thank you. I'll just go see how this works against some enemies. Yeah, pretty decent. I like it. Right. Remember, this is also a D20. I always forget that and end up dropping something on the floor and then re-rolling it by accident. I knew that was going to be a secret room. I was about to place a bomb and it just opened. I don't really know how I accidentally bombed myself out of it as well. Another head. Okie dokie. I'm just popping stuff to get charges, by the way. If you're wondering why I'm just popping things randomly. See, like, I placed a bomb there, but the secret room opened before the bomb even went off. Got him before he grew up, just about. Planetarium there, didn't even realize we had a planetarium this floor. Nice. Oh, we don't have keys right now. There's a key. Lovely. Ooh. This is kind of interesting. Ah, it's not as interesting as I'd have hoped. It unfortunately does not give us charges. I was really hoping it would. That would have been pretty gnarly for charges if it had given us charges. What we got going on in here? Ooh, I will come back to you if I get keys. But right now I enter here. Player can walk over pits every 10 seconds. Wormwood attacks enemies and special rocks from below, dealing 40 damage. Well, that's interesting. It's different. That doesn't work with time machine, sadly. Air throw as well. We got a pair thrower and a D6 shard. I'm willing to drop bank on this guy to get him to pay out. Also, the wisps are really, really useful because we've got Flechette. Flechette makes the wisps way stronger. Hey, we gained cancer there as well. Lovely. Saccharum play is plausible. Hey, there you go. Zodiac is not bad. Right, let's go into our item room real quick here. Oh, Wormwood is doing his thing. My god, he's destroying a lot of stuff. They just destroy one thing when we enter a room. It's kind of nice. Ooh, I will just take the glasses. The glasses are very good. We have a lot of friends. We have a lot of hibbity-hobbity fellas right now. I'm going to stick on my dice shard for now. I might come back for you, Pairthrower. We will see. It's a long way to come back, unfortunately. Yeah, so at the start of every room, Wormwood's just going to ruin a fella. We can also... They said we could walk over pits. Oh, wait, there you go, I see. So we walk into a pit and then it fills. Technically, we can't walk over them. It just fills them in as we do. Right, you're dead. Good. Probably should go to our shop, shouldn't we, if we can? Although we don't have a key right now, so right now we can't. Hey, there you go. Whenever I say that, the game always gifts me with a key straight away. A luck down, but our luck was already down. Whatever this is, can you go away, please? I just went in this door. If I walk in and... Okay, it does spawn it. I mean, I don't need my money right now, so I'm going to see what actives we can get from this. Probably won't be anything better than this. But you never know, right? Ooh, ha-ha. That's actually very, very good. There you go. We learnt a permanent ability there. We actually showed that off in a previous run. I kind of want to take that with me, you know. I'm going to take that with me. We're switching our active out like crazy, I'll be honest. But we have the chance for charged pennies. So, like, there's a chance that we get a lot of charges for this. Oh, wait, dude. I'm so stupid. I have dice shard. Oh, and we got Smelter. And then I guess we come back in and reroll again. I'll go back and grab the pair thrower. Although I could put the pair thrower into the hex table and gain a stat increase, though. Although I think it's potentially slightly more likely that we'll get better from utilizing the actual pair thrower to reroll stuff, right? I don't know. Kind of hard to say. Honestly, just walk out here. It's just quicker. A half heart isn't actually that valuable to us right now. This run is said and done. We got Birthright! Yes! And we get Guppy's Eye. What the hell's this? Burnt Baby. Shoots fire. 10% chance to explode an enemy on impact. Yeah, I'll take that. And we got Lammer Box Aim Assist. I don't really know what that means. But I guess we'll be finding out shortly. 48 energy. Oh my god. Oh, Solar Bethany, yes. Engraved. Stats, dude. I'm enjoying myself a lot here. This is some cool stuff. This is some cool stuff. Aubrey absolutely paying out for us. Right, you are about to get absolutely massacred, my good guy. I know that you're a champion, but still. Massacred is the word I use, and I stand by it. Once your little minions are dead. This shotgun effect thing is just gonna just ruin you. Oh, you're spawning fires. I'm so scared. Beautiful. Burnout treatment, I'm not that involved with. Blazing Iris, Orbital, that's kinda nice. Broken Hearts can now be used to buy devil deals. Not super useful for us, I don't think. Yeah, I'm not gonna take experimental treatment. I don't have any other syringes, do I? Yeah. I don't think it's worth it. I think the chances of getting a fire rate or damage down are reasonably high, and I don't really want either of those. Thank you. What does this do? Spawns one pill, converts all pills into spirit pills. Ooh. The balls of steel. Spirit pills are pretty amazing, to be honest. Well, this is a telepills. This won't really work the way I want it to. Boom, look at that. Spirit pills is a really cool idea. God damn, that's an increase to our fire rate by a hefty amount. Off mixed with whatever spirit that was. Oh, this is the one that spawns a bunch of like burnies and stuff, isn't it? All the gravestones. Spawn friends when I destroy them. Yeah, pills in combat are now very, very effective. Explosive. Diarrhea. Don't really know what hurt me then. That might have been Phantom Pains. I honestly don't know. Don't really know where I'm going here. We found our item room, so that's good. Although we don't have a key right now. Although I've just mentioned about not having a key, so the game is probably going to be generous in this next room. No? Pathro, I will just have... Thank you. It's a good way to get more runes in general, but then also we can gain stats from the bad ones and permanent upgrades from the soul ones. Ow, that hurt me. That's not a key either. Assassin guy, don't stab me. I see you. Damn game. It's been brutal right now. We got breakfast. Don't really know where that came from. But do you know what? Honestly, I'll take it. I could have pair-throwed it, but I'm waiting on a devil deal or something to pair-throw, I think. Far more useful in that scenario. A lot of enemies. Ooh, I'm going to have myself a taco for lunch, and I bought myself some smoked cheddar, and oh my god, it's hella smoky. I'm kind of excited for it, to be honest. Do we have piercing? Or does Model Rocket just have piercing by default? It might well have piercing by default. Dan Tooting, give us what we need. We really need a key, or two. Two would be better. Careful of all these guys. Good thing is we don't have to worry too much about taking damage. I've only got a few more rooms to work with here, though. Good thing is we can fill in these gaps. Really? Kind of sad now. No key come our way. Oh my god, so many of the brimstone guys. Little worried about my health now. I thought it wasn't going to be a problem, but I'm not really seeing the blended hearts in a little while. Yeah, we're seeing a lot of half red hearts, which don't blend. We got some stats from that, thank you. And that also counted as using a pill, apparently. Hello, good sir. Don't really know what I can expect to get from you, but burn heart's not bad. Just get a bunch of spiders ready and then go play the Burtman. That's my plan here. Spiders and flies at the ready, and we'll beast on it. Music's going hard right now. Dude, this guy is stealing all my money. Right. I'll pay for you with my last remaining pennies. Managed to spend all my money on him and he didn't even give me an item. That's kind of funny that creates a path. Right, these shouldn't be too hard. I mean, they are on later floors, which does make them harder, but... Is this not over? Oh wait, no, it is over. Make sure we don't take a teleport penny. If you get a chaos penny, don't walk into it. Where did all the charmed goats come from? Do not know. A key! I knew it would be worth doing this. We've got so many friends to work with here. This has been pretty good. And we can pair throw the item if it's not something we want. What are you going to give us? Ooh, Brittle Burns. Brittle Burns is an interesting and risky one. We get a lot of fire rate increase off of the back of Brittle Burns. I think I'll take it. Into the boat we go. Yeah, so we can lose a bunch of these burn hearts in order to bolster ourselves a little bit with fire rate, but definitely makes us weaker overall.
Shot speed up.
Right. Come on, guys. I also got invincibility here, which I didn't really want. I'm looking to hurt myself right now. Ah, the invincibility is kind of annoying me. Right, one more. Ah, invincibility, stop! Cool, okay. Now we're at a bit of a risky point here, so I've got to play this a little safer. Pick up some hearts and stuff. We are still trying to win, remember. Item room, I'm coming to you. Honestly, just bomb through, it's quicker. Bone spurs. I'll take bone spurs. Why not? Not quite perthro necessary. Right, so we're going into the boss fight in a little bit of a risky way here. But I'm ready to face the music. You know what? I'm willing to even do this. Very risky, but I'm willing. So we got that. I'm gonna try bomb this. There's a chance to get an item from it when I bomb it. I've got a mod that does that. And to be honest, we'll grab a battery for this as well. Third item is only 1 cent. 1 cent for 2 cent. Yes! What a deal. Soul of Golem. Petrification. And that's fear when we enter a room, right? Can't remember if that's the one that does that. We have such high fire rate now, though, that the shotgun effect is going off a lot, and we're going to be doing a lot of damage. Coming down had a hard time with that, apparently. So many of these heads, but nowhere to spend them yet. Right, give knife piece. I don't know, like, it's spelled to... Oh. Right, let's go. Ooh. The heart floats. Why are you floating, heart? I honestly don't know. Holy mantle is gone. I didn't even realize I had a holy mantle, but it's gone. Ooh. The blazing iris thing is like deleting tears on occasion, spawning fires instead. I didn't notice that so far, but that's a nice effect. I like that. Right, down we go. I think that's the blazing iris that's doing that at least. The little eye that's floating around is what we got from the devil deal. Oh, wow. We got Mortis. I forgot we had Mortis installed. This is why we want to do this sort of stuff. Can reward random items, beggar leaves, activating a black rune? Ooh. Child's Heart. That's actually a decent trinket to take for us here. Play that again. Ooh. Tosses a rock at the nearest enemy in a short distance. Where'd my Child's Heart go? What? I'm confused. I don't really know what happened there. But this floor is no joke. This floor is pretty hard. We've got to be wary, on our toes, because I don't know a lot of the enemies here. I've never seen that guy before. I don't know how they work, and they can do some pretty gnarly stuff, I imagine. Also, they seem to have an extraordinary amount of health. Whoa, look at these guys. Oh, God. Didn't know they were brimstone. You see, this is what I'm talking about. Like, the risk is very high right now. We gotta be careful. Another one of these guys. Honestly, bomb him. I don't know how that brimstone didn't hit me, but I'm very thankful it didn't. I love the visuals on this floor. It's probably the best looking floor in the entire game. Thought that was a secret room. Lovely. Ooh, two water balls here is good.
Phantom pains.
Got speed. I'm not sure which thing this is, but I'm going to go try using it. Hoping it's some sort of damage aura or something. I don't know. You're stuck in the wall. Oh, it's reverting things and herming them back. Do you know, I think Phantom Pains is actually hurting me. I was saying it wasn't working. I think it's working too well now. Not ideal. One second. Right, let's keep this going. Keep this going. We're on a long run here, but this is min-maxing, baby. That's what we do. Ah, goddammit. We did gain fire rate out of that, though. My health is looking a little worse for wear for Mother, to be honest. I really expected to have gained more by now. Andromeda. Ethereal Recall. Quite know what that does, but excited to find out. I think we're going to make our way back to our arcade in a sec. I've not had as many money drops as I was hoping for here, let's be honest. That's a butt penny, come on. Heart pennies, where you at? That's another butt penny. Oh, this game's being silly to me right now. I will say the 10.17 fire rate is basically soy milk level, so in that regard, things are going very well. I guess I'll take that just to see what happens. Yeah, there you go. Still taking my pair throw just in case. The bomb. Hey, we did go the right way. Good. I'm looking for one more penny so I can get two more players on the thingy here. On the arcade machine. The crane game is what I'm talking about. Bombs are key. Whoa! Where did all that fire come from? Back we go. I could do the rest of this floor in the hopes that I get better stuff here, but I think the likelihood of that isn't great. I should try it though, shouldn't I? I should. Should not leave it up to chance. That's good. That could have been a lot better. Some of these severed heads have nothing to do with them. One more penny. There you go, and it was a key as well. Okay, we've got a decent chance of getting tech 2 here, which I'd like, considering our fire rate is so high. It's not going to detriment us too much. Don't be a bastard. You're a bastard. Right, get bombed. At least you gave me a soul heart, but that is a bit rude. I could have really used that. Our health is looking slightly better now, though. Charge. Right, boss time. Ooh, damn. What does this do again? Prevents stats from being increased while held. Okay, I'll take that for now. Gotta remember to drop it when we need to increase our stats in any way. I forget what the bosses on this floor do, so I'm a little wary here. But also, this fat body over here, I don't know if that's part of the boss, but it's taking a lot of damage. I think it is. Oh my god. Thank you, Blanket. HP, I like that. Lump of coal would be very nice. Lump of coal is indeed very nice. Good stuff. Thor Andromeda, which will just give us stats. I don't know why the soul stones are counting as pills with this machine, this hexen table. Kind of weird, but must be just something to do with the way they coded it. Right, good stuff. Oh god, this is kind of a crazy room here. A lot going on, but yeah, Lump of Coal is kind of huge for us. Speed down. Be nice if it told us what the thing he did in the ID as well. This one. Phantom pains. I'd like this one. I'm going to take that with me. I know it's a speed down, which isn't ideal, but the effect of it is, I think, the fire, which is... I think that burns through boss armor, if I remember correctly, which would be very, very good for first phase. Now we just got to actually find the boss. Ah! No! Oh, I saw him coming and I still couldn't get out of the way in time. He came at some speed there. Die, disembodied head. Why are you so hearty? Or heady? This is just regular corpse now. No more mortis. Oh god, I got hurt by the poison. Taking some rough hits right now. Very stupid rough hits. Give me some hearts. That's not a heart, that's a penny. Over range, we do quite literally insane damage there. We fire across a room, everything just melts. Sick of your damn pennies. Your damn lies. Hello, little spider. I didn't really aim at you. You just kind of died in my presence. Where's the big fella? I hear him. There he is. Last little stretch here. I'll take it. Oh, baby! That was unexpected. Devil disc. That was very unexpected, I've got to say. This is entrance to the boss trap room as well, which is also unexpected. More HP is good. I would like to use some of these items on the boss, but I don't think we're going to make it before these devil discs run out. We've only got 60 seconds. We've already used like 20 of those. Do not like the idea of this attack. But we should be able to kill him before it hits me. Yes. Oh, what? Oh, I walked right into that tier. That was so stupid. Death card there, cheeky. Right. Zoom, zoom, zoom. That was a black heart there. We'll go back and grab that. Little spider, please hurry up and die. Oh, I walked into it as well. I'm so stupid today. I'm so stupid. I thought it'd die faster. You always expect them to die faster. Hold up, is Lusty Blood not working? Why are we not gaining damage? Or have I got the wrong... No, we do have that one. Why are we not gaining damage from Lusty Blood here? We're not actually killing the enemies properly or something? I don't really know what's going on here. That was a good item to not have worked for us. Also, what's going on with this big guy? Another speed down. Ow. No, my trials. My glorious trials. Oh god, we're heading into the boss fight with not as much health as I'd really have hoped. Baby Bender? Oh! We're not gaining stats because of my trinket. Okay, we'll swap out my trinket. Baby Bender, I guess. It's you now. Although Baby Bender turned into a stone trinket for some reason. That must be to do with the petrification thing. Damage and extra damage. Okay, I'll just take the damage then, I guess. Thank you. We've got to be close to the boss at this rate. We've got to be nearby. Okay. Didn't realize we had this floor, but there you go. Oh, because we had the trinket where our stats couldn't raise, we never actually found out about that item. It's kind of funny how that's been working for us, or against us, in a way. Okay, I got hit there as well. Not good. I'm so torn on what to do here. I'm gonna do a few more rooms if I can. Just try and get another charge of my active mainly. I could get another secret power that could help us out. Or I could just get a soul stone that's really good. And could just take it in and use it. But at the minute I'm pretty set on using the speed down. Which seems a bit weird, but I think the flames that it spawns should be very good. And also take this half heart here, which I kind of need. You. One more room will be out of here. Don't take any damage in this room, please. Well, this will do something. I don't know what. Culinary mastery. Okay. It is boss time. I am a little bit scared. We do not have the most health for this. So, we shall see how it goes. I could take the joy pill. I think that gives us double damage until we next get hit. But honestly, I'm not confident that I won't get hit. So I don't think that's super useful. Right. Let's do this. We do get Holy Mantle, which is nice. That did not do what I thought it would do. Okay. I mean, it seems to do a good amount of damage to him. So it's not bad. That's not the effect I was expecting. Yeah, that wasn't ideal. A lot of these tears are going to turn to fire, which is nice. He's still bleeding and brimstone cast. Probably should have used that in the second phase, to be honest. Because of the bleeding. But, like I said, I didn't know it was going to happen. I didn't know that's what it was going to do. All of them are brimstone cast as well, which is strange to see. We've managed to keep our Holy Mantle for the entire first phase thus far. That's good to see. We got a severed head from this guy as well. Oh, we finally got one of these teleports, but a little bit late. We could use it now and get an eight severed head item and then redo the first phase, but I feel like that'd be ill-advised. We don't have any bombs, unfortunately. Bombs make this second phase a significant amount easier if he does his charge attack, which he likely will. Oh, dude, you see the amount of tears that destroy them? This burning iris thing is pretty goddamn good. We also need to remember to try and stay as far away from him as we can. We'll deal more damage the further distance we get from him. because of Lump of Coal and because of our model rocket item. Unfortunately, these little shotgun shots that we fire, these angelic shotgun shots, knock us back. So I'm kind of being knocked into the tiers here. He's doing it. He's going for it. Oh, dude. You ran through every single fire there. That wasn't too bad for us. Okay. In the home stretch now. That ended up being way more okay in this fight than I thought we'd be, which is really nice. I thought we were going to have a really hard time here, but game did not treat us too poorly. We have this guy very much taken care of. I hope you guys did enjoy this one. It was a lot of fun and a start to a beautiful streak, hopefully. As I said, these episodes will be longer due to the min-maxing nature of the episodes, as you can tell by this one. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy this and we can see more to come. I'll see you guys in the next one.